God can change a person. I'm a walk-in, talk-in testimony of the miracle power of Jesus Christ. Before I met Jesus, I was a whoremonger. I was a drug dealer. I did anything and everything I could to make money. And God changed me, fixed me in a minute. He turned my life around in a minute as soon as I wanted to change. The problem is you don't want to change. That's why you don't want it to be true. Jesus Christ is Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And every single knee here is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess one day. Sadly, it's going to be too late for most of you on that day. Most of you are going to bow and confess to your condemnation because you're finally going to give in to the truth. You're going to finally give in to the truth that Jesus was Lord all along and you've been mocking Him and scourging Him all your life. And then you're going to pay the punishment due for your rebellion on that day. It doesn't have to be that way. Jesus Christ died to set you free. You need to turn to Him and be set free. That's the gospel. Jesus Christ is mighty. He's able. He's able to save. Do you want to be saved? That's the question. Or do you like your sin? That's the problem. You like your sin, that's the problem. Light came into the world and men chose darkness. That's the truth. The time is short. Jesus Christ is coming back. He's not coming back like a little baby this time. He won't be coming back in swaddling clothes. He won't be coming back as a little child. No, he's coming back full grown, mighty, with the sword. Angry with the wicked every day. God is tired of you misrepresenting Him. God is tired of you lying about Him. Yes, Muhammad was a pedophile. God never used him as a prophet. Aisha was a 6-year-old girl. That's disgusting. It's time to consider your ways, folks. Jesus Christ is coming back with the sword of vengeance. And this is His world, whether you fool yourself or not. This is not the devil's world. Oh no. The devil, he reigns over this place because you give him rule and authority. If you'd stop giving him authority, he'd stop having it. It's real simple. You love your life more than you love God. Jesus said, if you love me, you keep my commandments. That's how you know that you don't love God. You think you love God. You say, well, I love Him, but He understands. He knows my heart. He gave you a Bible so you didn't have to go by your heart. He gave you a Bible. You know what a Bible costs? Probably a little less than a full-size pizza at any pizza place. You could get a Bible. Yes, you could get a Bible and you could read it and live. Well, that's a foolish thing to have. That pizza will be gone, well, by the looks of you, in about 10 minutes. But
no, listen to this, man. He's right.
The Bible will last you forever. It's all good. The world revolves around you because you got enough money to buy a city. Whoop-dee. Well, God doesn't care about your money. Your money is going to perish with you.
Ways.
Drunkards go to the same place that murderers and thieves go. That's right. It's not given for a prince to drink wine. Jesus Christ is my elder brother. He's the King of Kings. I'm a prince. I don't need no booze. That's the Bible. He said you give strong drink to those that perish. What are you all perishing of anyway? You look perfectly healthy. You're killing yourself with booze, and your sin is going to find you out.
Repent! Believe the gospel!